Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have did a lecture which was based on the types of intermolecular interactions, in which the first one was dipole-dipole interaction. And now we are going to do a very detail about what is actually a dipole-dipole interaction. So let us do it. So friends, we are now going to talk about what is dipole-dipole interaction. So for the first thing that we should know is what is actually a dipole. So for that, we know that a dipole is a polar molecule in which a partial positive and partial negative charge are separated by a definite distance, and it has a permanent dipole moment. So this kind of molecules are basically known as polar molecules. And what are polar molecules actually? Polar molecules are those molecules which have positive charge as well as negative charge. For an instance, let me tell you that if I'm talking about a molecule like HCl, because we know that HCl has H atom and Cl atom, they both are being binded with each other by the chemical bond, and in which the hydrogen is which basically a partially positive charged part atom. While talking about the chlorine is a negative charged atom which is present in the overall molecule of HCl. So this positive charge and this negative charge has a kind of attraction between them, and hence this kind of molecules are known as polar molecules because of that charge separation, that is for positive charge and for the negative charge. So this was only about a dipole. So when we're talking about dipole-dipole interaction, so what we are saying that a dipole is now interacting with another dipole. So therefore, the interaction between two dipole molecules is nothing but the dipole-dipole interaction. So let us go with another deep detail so that we could understand it better. So basically, dipole-dipole interactions results in generating force of attraction between the neighbor polar molecules due to attraction between the two oppositely charged ends of the polar molecule. So what does this say? Suppose if I am talking about a molecule like HCl, which is a polar molecule as I have explained it. So suppose if I am taking another molecule of HCl and they both are nearby to each other. So what will happen is they will have a force of attraction. And how? Because suppose in HCl, the Cl which is having a partially negative charge, it will attract the another molecule which has a positive charge. So it is not only necessary that HCl will attract with HCl, it can be for anyone. So therefore, a dipole-dipole interaction is for those molecules which are itself dipole, so that they will form an interaction with another dipole, that is the one which has a permanent dipole moment and which is basically polar in nature. So now talking about the next one, that is, this interaction arises due to electrostatic force of attraction. Yes, and this is because of the electrostatic force of attraction, because they have negative charge as well as they have positive charge within the molecule, and they interact with other molecules also. So let me give you an example in short so that you could understand in a better way. I will take the example of HCl itself. Suppose if I have taken a molecule like HCl, and I know that HCl consists of H atom and Cl atom, in which the H has partially positive charge while the Cl has partially negative charge. Suppose if nearby the atoms, or sorry, nearby the molecules which are also present nearby of HCl, which is nothing but we could say that I have another molecule of HCl, similarly I have another molecule of HCl. So these are the neighboring molecules, they are very close to the HCl that has been present in a overall a volume of HCl which is present in a gaseous state or which is present in a liquid state. So what will happen is, in this case also, if we could see that this H is a polar molecule, everything is a polar molecule. So therefore this will have a partially positive charge, while this will have Cl will have a partially negative charge, while that of this HCl H also, which has a partial positive charge, while this Cl has partially negative charge. So what will happen is, this HCl which itself is a molecule, while this HCl is also a molecule similar to that of this HCl. So what will happen is, the negative charge, as you could see for the Cl, so it will try, it is attracting with, or they have a force of attraction of Cl with this H, but when it comes to another molecule, this Cl will have an interaction with another a molecule which has a positive charge. So therefore this Cl will have interaction with the another H molecule which has a partially positive charge. So it could be said like this also, that this H plus has an interaction with the Cl which is nearby to it, and this Cl is of another molecule, that is of HCl only. So now what will happen is this minus charge, that is partially negative charge, that is on Cl, it will try to attract with the another positive charge. Initially it has been attracted to H plus within the molecule, so it will try to form a bond with another molecule. So therefore this is what we are going to see. So there will be kind of force of attraction between them, because, and this force of attraction will be nothing but the electrostatic force of attraction, because as we can see that this H is positive charge while this Cl is negative charge, they are opposite charges, and hence we know that opposite charges attract with each other. So this kind of interaction where we see is nothing but the interaction between a dipole molecule and another dipole molecule. So therefore the interaction between two dipole molecules is said to be dipole-dipole interaction. Very much easy to understand. So it is not necessary, as I've said earlier also, that it is not necessary that HCl will only bind with HCl to form a dipole-dipole interaction. It can bind with any other molecule also, where which is a basically a dipole, or which is basically a substance which consists of a permanent dipole moment, or which is actually a polar molecule. So this kind of interaction with the two dipoles or with two polar molecules between them is known as dipole-dipole interaction. And talking about this thing is because this is having a force of attraction, that is electrostatic force of attraction, so that makes a dipole-dipole interaction much more stronger among all the types of interaction that we have learned in our previous lecture. So this makes the dipole-dipole much more stronger, and hence this is what dipole-dipole interaction means. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very thoroughly, and we are going to do more topic on this interactions. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.